Right. Right.
I 65.
Eel skin. His wife got him some eel skin. His ex-wife. Or
I have to go and tell Robinson is opening up his airplane. He called the other day.
Do you have one landed before?
Sound
Yeah, I thought I could see something down there mm-hmm. on the runway. And,
it's amazing how well those deer get camouflaged.
And then somebody called on the radio and said there's some deer on the runway. Mm-hmm. And then I saw them kind of walking away, walking off. So I this guy was a flight instructor, and he was up flying with a student, and he didn't have his certificate with him. His certificate was in the office. And after they came down and they parked the airplane, they're walking in back into the office, and some FAA inspector.
Oh, look, we got champs.
So wants to see his certificate. He says, "Okay, I'll get it for you. It's right in the office here." What? You don't have it on you?
It is.
The wind can get real tricky close to the ground. Luckily, there isn't much wind today.
Yeah. Means you can't blame your landing on anything. Yeah. See a lot of guys around here.
So who's there, right?
Yeah.
Well, they're down there signing up for the Concord.
Well, did you sign up for the experimental at 99's there?
Yes.
Oh, yeah, we got the winning ticket.
Do you? No.
My wife does.
Oh.
She says, "Hey, you own two airplanes. It's about time I own one."
Well, that lady lied to me. She said I
had to be.
Slipping it a little bit there. Look at that. Oh, the old Balaka. Yeah. That's right. That was our Grand Champion Award winner 2 years ago. If I remember. No, we're still looking.
Oh, look at that.
Do they know that's good news? Did they just tell everybody to come?
Oh, do they? A little bit of a crosswind developing here.
Yeah. That's a gallon though.
Yeah, the student prince.
Yeah, that's the same gallon.
She is.
What they were suggesting is they would give exemptions on an airport-by-airport basis, and the AOPA says, oh, we don't want that. That's ridiculous. Everybody agrees that under 2,500 feet is nothing. So if it was to come out 10 or 15 miles and say under 2,500 feet...
Yeah.
I know it. I looked in there this morning when I left. It's still all in pieces. I found out that mine leaks like a damn sieve.
Somebody is?
Why doesn't he use Chris?
Well, he says Chris told him Chris said that Chris wasn't finished yet.
About Blanca wings rotting and falling off while my Mooney is.
He's out of
anchorage.
You run down, you get on the jet, don't care enough.
That's a 120 from my eye. Did you see last year this guy just
show
took off and didn't
yeah,
did.
Down and he said, you know. You gotta stay on top of it. He said that thing got slower than me.
Yeah, 150 horses.
Yeah, I got up to 3,000 feet, you know, and he's out there and he's giving it this number. And rolling it over so he gets up.
Good engine.
He landed in the school parking lot, so he saved himself.
Everything to make it.
Ted. Oops. It is, isn't it? No, it's these Canadian numbers.
Oh.
Back
on.
The sound of a
I bet you tomorrow that, I mean tomorrow, next year, I bet you the taxi is on the other side.
Yeah. Listen to the sound. I love it.
Yeah, sounds good, doesn't it?
Sometime this year before I go out of office, so he's got to hang around.
Yeah, the guy that pulls around behind his pickup?
Yeah.
No, that's the guy, okay.
Here he comes.
We've got her down, too.
Look at
that thing come.
Over the arm.
Yeah. You can ask as much as you want, all right?